like leadership, nursing, and her faith. Rosalie has been a leader all of her life. Starting from being a young girl, when her friends would come over, and Rosalie would often be the boss whenever they would play. As a child, she also would be the first in line to bandage someone's wound, even if she may have gone a little overboard and wrapped her father's entire hand for a minor cut. Needless to say, he was a butcher, so she got a lot of practice. Before entering her freshman year, she lived as a mother's helper for two children and earned $5 a week, just enough to pay for her first year of tuition, and it was definitely worth it. During high school, Rosalie truly flourished. She made lifelong friendships and truly embraced her faith. This was also where she met her mentor and sister Bernadette. This was someone that Rosalie wanted to pattern her life after. She was extremely ladylike, with an appearance that demanded respect, and when she walked into the room, everyone would fall silent. Moving on after high school, Rosalie always tried to model her leadership after sister Bernadette. Rosalie's professional career began at Good Samaritan Hospital and ended with her being the executive director for the Ohio Board of Nursing. During her last act in office, it became official that every registered nurse must have the red RN symbol on their name badge in order to identify themselves, which is very important to Rosalie. This is a passion for Rosalie because she believes that you should always be able to tell who the nurse is. That way you know who to look for. And there were also many other stops along that journey, including both her Bachelor of Science and Master's degree from the Ohio State University. Rosalie is an avid Ohio State football fan. As one of her classmates, Dorothy, stated, "The only thing better than this award would be to dot the I during halftime of the Buckeyes." Rosalie also has been deeply rooted in her faith her entire life and is still extremely active in her parish, St. Paul, which is directly in her backyard. On Tuesdays, you'll also be able to find her taking communion to the patients at Cypress. It is my great pleasure to introduce our 2013 Professional Achievement Award recipient, Rosalie Weiner.
And good evening to everyone, especially my relatives and friends who have joined me here tonight, right? All the bakers at this front table here. I particularly want to recognize one of my patients that, as was mentioned, I take communion to Cypress in Cypress Point Health Center in Englewood, Mildred Bynack and her daughter Taffy, who graduated from Joanne, lives in Washington, D.C., and came here to bring her mother to this affair to surprise me. Aww. Indeed, I was very surprised. There, okay. Okay. I didn't know exactly where they were. What a thrilling experience it was to receive that phone call from Bo, informing me that I had been selected to be inducted into the CJ Distinguished Alumni Hall of Fame. This recognition is indeed the capstone of my professional career. I want to publicly thank my classmates, sitting at the next table, for nominating me. My 4 years at Julianne High School were without a doubt some of the very best years of my life, and I treasure the friendships that I made then and still have today. They are gathered at that table down there. So. Of course, I go way back when the nuns wore habits and registered nurses wore white uniforms with caps, and the tuition at Julianne was $120 a year with the student's parish paying half of it. And as was mentioned, I graduated in 1942, and after I graduated from Our Lady of the Rosary grade school, I got a summer job as a mother's helper, for which I was paid $5 a week. And by the end of the summer, I had earned and saved $60, my first year tuition at Julianne, and I was so proud of that. When I think back over my life, I realize that my days at Julianne were some of the very best experiences. Mm-hmm. The first person that comes to mind, as Bo mentioned, was Sister Bernadette Marie, and those of you who graduated from Julianne know of whom I am speaking. She was the school's first principal who remained in that position during my years there. To me, she was the epitome of womanhood and authority. Her appearance alone commanded respect, and I wanted to pattern my adult life after her. It was during my high school years that my moral foundation was cemented and my Catholic faith strengthened. The experience of Julianne High School made me the person I am today. Now a little about my career in nursing. When I was mentioned that ever since I was 4 years old, I wanted to be a nurse. But when I was 4 years old, I was hospitalized at the old St. Elizabeth's Hospital, which overlooked the Great Miami River. One night I was crying for my mother, and somebody, not a nurse, but somebody, maybe a cleaning person or a mop man or somebody, said, "Oh, your mommy jumped in the river." Well, then I did cry. And a lady, I know it was a nurse because she had a white uniform on, she picked me up and held me and called my mother, but held me in her arms until my mother came. And when I got home, after being getting out of the hospital, when I got home, I told my mother I wanted to be a nurse and make people comfito. I couldn't say comfortable at age 4, but I wanted to make people comfito. That's all I ever wanted to be, and that's what I gave 50 years of my life being. After graduating from Julianne in 1946, I entered nurse's training at Good Samaritan and worked in the operating room for 16 years. In 1959, I scrubbed for the first open heart surgery, only the second procedure done in the state of Ohio. Ultimately, I took a position, as was mentioned, in Columbus, and my last position was as executive director of the Ohio Board of Nursing. When I retired that position, I had fulfilled 50 years of nursing. I never married, but I was blessed with supportive siblings and have a number of caring nieces and nephews, some of whom are here tonight. I'm currently very involved at my parish, St. Paul's Catholic Church, in the Nurses Associations on the state level and the local level. And my alumni associations, especially Julianne. In 1996, we celebrated our 50th anniversary, then our 60th, and our 65th. Then we began celebrating our milestone birthdays, our 80th birthday, so we all turned 80 at the same time, our 80th, and most recently, our 85th birthday. We decided our 90th birthday party will probably be celebrated in a nursing home somewhere. But I enjoy being MC at all of these special celebrations. Over the years, I have received several professional recognitions, but none has meant as much to me as this recognition from my high school